Ladies and gentlemen, I am SidAlpha, and while I know there are more than a few people that were wanting me to discuss the easy anti-cheat situation with Epic Games and their pausing Linux support, I have reached out to them for an official response, and when I do that, I have to, in good conscience, wait for at least a full 24-hour period before I continue on. That said, there have been some goings-on with Anthem that I do feel bears discussing, and while I wish I had good news for everyone, I think it's about time to stick a fork in Anthem. I think it's done. The reasons for that are due to a couple of different factors that aren't, let's face it, entirely BioWare's fault. Of course, we all know full well by now, as we saw from Mass Effect Andromeda and again with Anthem, that the management team at BioWare is missing something. Whatever that might be, I honestly can't say without having more information than we as outsiders will ever be able to get. Regardless, the development company has seemed to be rudderless for quite some time, and as a result, a great many people, myself included, are extremely worried that they might end up fucking up a third IP in the form of Dragon Age 4. But before I go too deep into my own thoughts, let alone a full-blown rant, let's run through the particular facts that we'll be drawing from here. Oh, and I decided at the behest of a couple of ridiculous people on Twitter to post a funding goal over at Ko-Fi or Coffee or whatever.com that once reached, I will record a full rant video reading the McDonald's menu. Because if anyone can rant about a double quarter pounder meal related to video games and make it sound intelligent, it would be this guy, I think. But if you're interested in engaging in some nonsense, buy me a coffee or Ko-Fi or whatever, link is in the description down below. So, over the course of the past several days on Twitter, it's come out that several key people are being moved from the Anthem project to Dragon Age 4. Executive producer Mark Dara's Twitter post on May 1st indicates that the Edmonton office is switching away from Anthem. Also on May 1st, another executive producer, Michael Gamble, confirmed that he was no longer on the Anthem project and directed people to Ben Irving, a lead producer for Anthem, and Chad Robertson, the head of BioWare's live services. It's also worth noting that it initially seemed that BioWare was shifting Anthem over to the Austin, Texas team. However, this was actually already confirmed as far back as April 14th by Mike Gamble that BioWare Austin is responsible for Anthem and for the upcoming new content release for Star Wars The Old Republic. On the 2nd of May, Chad Robertson posted the following. We remain 100% committed to Anthem and look forward to showing players the new content we are working on. We want to make sure we aren't overpromising, so our updates on what's coming in the game will be focused when we have things near completion. And Michael Gamble retweeted Robertson's statement with an affirmation that the studio's commitment hasn't changed. And I'm also going to refer to this post on Reddit made by Trask10100 titled, Can We All Just Agree That Anthem Is Dead? Now in that, they outlined the deplorable communication, the console version being so broken that it was practically breaking consoles, no endgame, the delays of promised content, and most of the rest of the issues that have plagued the game since even before its launch. And in spite of BioWare's assertions that they are supporting the game, the damage has already been done. Current viewership at the time of this recording was a total of 138 viewers on Twitch, down from 162 viewers during the prime evening viewing hours. By comparison, Destiny 2, a game that was released nearly two full years before Anthem, matched Anthem's 138 views with nearly 5,000 of its own, down from close to 7,000 during the peak evening streaming window. And per WCCFTech.com, Anthem's Act 1 calendar is already delaying the following features. Mastery System, Guilds, Legendary Missions Phase 2, Weekly Stronghold Challenge, Leaderboards, some free play events, and Cataclysm. So those are the basic facts that we're covering here in this video, and you know, I really don't buy what BioWare is trying to sell with the continued support. We already saw once with a failure of this magnitude that EA outright abandoned Mass Effect Andromeda instead of taking care of their customers and doing the right thing. Gone is the BioWare that cared about its customers and cared more about the game they were crafting than they did their bottom line. The vast majority, if not all of the staff that made BioWare the gaming darling that it was, are now gone and have been for quite some time, with only a few stragglers slowly shuffling out the door. BioWare has been fully and completely corporatized by the publicly traded EA, who cares far more for their shareholders' pockets than they do crafting the art that video games have the potential to be. I'm quite certain that if it weren't for the abandonment of Andromeda causing such a severe backlash and the fact that this is a live services title that they still need to try and bilk some form of profit out of, they would merely abandon this game as well and move on to screw up Dragon Age 4. Anthem was on life support before it even launched. This is beyond contestation. If it were the BioWare of old, it would have been all hands on deck to get the game patched and fixed up into a playable state. Now, who are we really kidding though? The BioWare of old wouldn't have allowed this to happen in the first place. BioWare relied on that quote-unquote BioWare magic while failing to remember one key important factor. When BioWare pulled off its most stunning successes, it did so as a unified team, with all people pulling in the same direction, with dynamic and effective leadership, and with talented staff. While they do still have talented staff, their leadership is fractured and disjointed, and the insular politics, bickering, and infighting has completely fractured the studios to the point where they are now all pulling in different directions. There's a term called circling the drain. What it is in relation to a multiplayer-only title such as Anthem is this. The game releases in an incomplete and broken state. It's boring, there's hardly anything to do, and what little content there is all essentially the same. This sameness, coupled with poor performance, no cohesion, and a lack of content, causes people to begin abandoning the game in droves. This in turn makes matchmaking in the multiplayer-only game more and more difficult. Then, frustration from the long wait times for matchmaking causes the already heinously terrible grind to feel even more grindy, driving even more people away. This in turn causes wait times for matchmaking to become even longer, and so on and so on and so on. It is quite literally a death spiral that once it goes too far along, it's exceptionally difficult to recover from. Anthem is dead. That is not in dispute, I think. Perhaps if it was the original BioWare team with all three of its offices working together to make something of the game, then maybe the circling the drain could have been counteracted. But it would seem that the new BioWare has shunted the game over to the Austin team to handle, and that won't be enough. Oh, it may recover some over the course of the next year or two, but the damage has already been done. And as for BioWare itself, well, we've already seen the writing on the wall for the past several years. BioWare 2 is circling the drain. And unfortunately, without the original team to pull up on the stick, I fear the once great development studio will continue to decline and to disappoint until Electronic Arts adds one more notch to its belt. You know, I joked about this a few times on social media, but I really do think I will fire up a Kickstarter to fund my creating a full documentary about the life of BioWare, how it rose to soaring heights as one of the jewels of the video gaming world, and then its subsequent fall from grace that led us to this point. It would be a huge investment of time and resources, but as BioWare is and was my favorite developers, I think it would only be fitting. So I think I'll start working towards that end, because I have a feeling that BioWare may not be with us for too much longer if Dragon Age 4 goes the way of Andromeda and Anthem. In the meantime, thank you so much for watching and indulging me in this bit of a rant video. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, I am SidAlpha, and I'll see you next time.